Hey guys, it's me, PaPokeman, and I'm here to talk about characters we could maybe see in Marvel Strike Force. So I don't think Fox Next Games is really looking at the first two Avengers Alliance games and saying, man, let's do this again, let's make Avengers Alliance 3. But I think they're definitely going to look at these first two games for a lot of inspiration. So while we're waiting for more news about the game, I say, let's talk about Avengers Alliance 1 and 2, because personally, I'd never played them, or at least I tried Avengers Alliance 1. I didn't really get into it. I thought it was kind of boring because you only had like Wolverine and Hawkeye, and I was pretty young, so I had a short attention span. And then Avengers Alliance 2, I kind of liked for a bit, but Avengers Alliance 2, I didn't stick around for long, and not that shortly after it got closed. So maybe, I guess it wasn't that good, Avengers Alliance 2. It depends on the fan base. It's a controversial thing. And I could talk about one day why both those games closed down, but that's not today's topic. We're going to look at the roster for these games. So they had 166 characters, and that's incredible. And to my knowledge, that's a record for the most Marvel characters in any Marvel game. And let's get right into those characters. So I can't even go over all those names because there's so many of them. And there's a lot of characters I didn't even know existed until about 10 minutes ago. We have Phantom X, Boomerang. I don't know who these guys are. Who's Kami? But look at all these cool characters they have. But you guys can look through them, see they have some of the Sinister Six there. And they actually had the Fantastic Four and the X-Men in this game, which is interesting. Now note, unlike Future Fight, where they have uniforms for characters, they do have, like, here we have Amazing Spider-Woman, and she's a separate character from Spider-Man and Superior Spider-Man. And Superior Spider-Man is a costume for Dr. Octopus in Future Fight. So they actually had everybody as separate characters, but I like how they did it here, as opposed to, you'll see in Avengers Alliance 2, where the separate characters are actually just different costumes for the characters, and you'll see what I mean later on. So here we have some more of the roster, and you can see they have different classes than Marvel Strike Force 2. They had Cloak and Dagger, which is sweet. Cloak and Dagger is awesome. But you can see Ant-Man, he's a common character you'll see a lot. Falcon, you'll see him a lot, that we do not see in this game. And Wasp, you'll see her a lot too. And Miles Morales, you see him a lot. Star-Lord, you'll see him a lot as well. And here we have the rest of the roster. So this is a pretty sweet roster. It's pretty incredible that they managed to fit this many characters in the game. And they have Moon Knight, and you'll see him often as well. So let's look at Avengers Alliance 2 to see what kind of characters they had. So now Avengers Alliance 2, of course, didn't go on for as long as the first Avengers Alliance, so they had a different roster of characters. But let's look at them real quick to see some of the characters, and can maybe give us an idea of who some of the core characters are that you want to have in your game. So we have Agent 13, Angela, Ant-Man right there. There he is. I don't believe we have Black Panther so far, so Black Panther, he's someone we want. Nothing too crazy here. But notice here for Captain America, they have different versions of him, but they're not like different multiverse versions of Captain America. They're just Captain America in his Civil War costume, Captain America in his Age of Ultron costume. I'm not a fan of them doing costumes as separate characters. I want them all to be one character with maybe uniforms with them. Unless it's a multiverse variant, then I'm okay with them being a separate character. Here you have Captain Marvel, a common character that we don't see in Marvel Strike Force. Some more of the Sinister Six, Electro. Falcon, there he is again. And Hank Pym, they added Hank Pym, that's pretty sweet. I'm pretty sure the other game had him too. Heimdall. Mr. Hyde, I don't know who Mr. Hyde is. They have MODOK, Moon Knight. Here's Nova. Nova is also a common character you'll see. She-Hulk, she's a common character. Miles Morales, Spider-Woman, Star-Lord, Wasp, and then we got War Machine, not in the other game, and along with Vision. I believe these two characters are not in Marvel Strike Force yet. So of course, this game didn't have as good of a roster as compared to Avengers Alliance 1, but it only went on for a fraction of the time. If we look back at Avengers Alliance, I believe they had like 32 seasons to their PvP. It's incredible how long that game went for. So hopefully this gives you guys an idea of who we might be seeing in Marvel Strike Force eventually, and the kind of characters these companies prioritize and they like to put in their games. Because Avengers Alliance 1, a huge circle of characters. Avengers Alliance 2 were some of the first characters they put into the game. So you can look at the Avengers Alliance 2 characters that were also in Avengers Alliance 1 that are not in Marvel Strike Force yet. That's the area we're looking at who are very likely to get into Marvel Strike Force relatively soon. So I'll talk to you guys later. Don't forget to subscribe. We're almost at 200 subs. And I'll talk to you guys later. Goodbye, everybody. They don't buy, they keep things loose, they keep things